woman who is the person of interest in the deaths of two elderly people in Volusia County is in more trouble today.
Yeah, she's accused of trying to pull off a fraud from behind bars. Investigators say Kimberly Smith got a friend to pose as a lawyer to defraud another inmate who is in need of an attorney. WESH 2's Claire Metz has more on the jailhouse scam.
They say truth can be stranger than fiction, and that's the case for Kimberly Smith. She's been in jail here since 2010, accused of stealing from seniors who were in her care. Those seniors were later found dead on her property. Now, Smith has not been charged in connection to the deaths, but she's accused of a jailhouse scheme, a fraud in March and April of this year.
Varying degrees of fraud on several different levels.
State Attorney R.J. LaRizza says 46-year-old Kimberly Smith, that's Smith wearing glasses in court, worked scams on the outside and got caught working one inside at the Volusia County Jail. Prosecutors say Smith convinced a friend, 46-year-old Mary Mitchell, to pose as a lawyer to get thousands of dollars in fees from another inmate who was dissatisfied with her own representation. That inmate is Vidya Boule. WESH 2 was there last year when Boule was arrested for investment fraud. Now she's allegedly the victim of another scammer. The state learned what Smith was up to in recorded calls Smith made from jail with Mitchell on the other end.
There's evidence based on conversations and recorded conversations, which certainly helps us to put our case together.
According to documents, Smith coached Mitchell on what to say, how to sound like an attorney. Inmate Boule wanted help for herself and her son who has immigration problems. Smith allegedly told Mitchell to say she'd previously practiced in Washington, D.C., that she had political connections there and was the niece of Governor Rick Scott.
Crime is only limited by the extent of the human imagination, and we all know that that's limitless.
Mitchell talked with the inmate victim by phone several times. According to the report, Smith always nearby. Mitchell asked at one point for $30,000, later settling for $17,000. The fraud was uncovered before money changed hands. Inmates are told calls from jail are recorded, and because Smith is under scrutiny in the deaths of two South Daytona seniors, her phone calls got more attention.
Only today, South Daytona police released the medical examiner's report in the deaths of seniors Goldie Mae Robinson and Arthur Sheldon. The two deaths are now considered a homicide, but there's still no known cause of death. In Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.